and what should not be inputted by other people if they are executing your program. Right? So enter the elements when I want to enter, so that appropriate message should be encoded in between your executions. This is the logic that we have already discussed, how it works. We have to understand why this n minus 1, because outer loop n minus 1 time execute hoti hai. Aap har ek element ko lekar baki elements ke sath compare karte ho, total n minus 1 times compare karte ho. Please take one example, n equal to 5, and try to know what will be the number of passes. If I say 5 elements, enter the elements of the array. So you finally get 2, 3, okay? Once again, properly document your program so that it is easily understood by you as well as somebody else who will execute your program. I hope this program is clear. Okay. And one last program we will discuss is about series. Just first let us see what is our series. This is our series. This is our series 1 upon x minus 2 upon x square plus 3 upon x cube. Okay, this is a given series. So first I have to make one term. Term is equal to 1. Right, and term can be incremented by previous term into 1 by x. आप देख सकते हो कि पहले 1 by x है, फिर आपकी हर एक टर्म में एक x, 1 by x is multiplied, right? So you can increase that term by 1 by x, right? Previous term multiply by 1 by x. Okay, so in this way you are adding new terms and you are storing the summation. Sum is equal to I into term, because आप देख सकते हो 1 by x, then second time it is 2 by x square. Third time it is 3 by x square. So I will help me to provide that 1, 2, 3. Numerator जो change हो रहा है वो, right? और आपकी sign भी change हो रही है. तो आप sign को कैसे manage करेंगे? Initially term को आपने positive लिया है. Second time term should become minus. तो आप sign change कर रहे हो, right? तो term is equal to minus. आप देख सकते हो ये program कैसे execute होता है? Term into 1 by x. Initially term is 1, right? 1 into 1 by x, then term becomes 1 by x into 1 by x, right? Sum is equal to I, that is 2 into 1 by x square when it goes for the second iteration, right? Then term is changing the sign also. Finally, you have to print the summation, right? See the execution, how it works. And we have to understand what should be the data type of x and what should be the data type of term, right? What should be the data type of sum? Okay, when you will execute, you will get this result. Okay, so try to learn the programming skills and make it easy for you. Instead of making it tough, take small logic and try to implement them. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.